Recently, I had been incrementing a lot of love for fishies. Come on, look at these cute innocent faces. But lately, I had been swimming deeply into the sea of programming. And I don't think I can spend time to take care of the real fishies. When there is a problem, the problem becomes the solution to another problem. So we are going to create an underwater visual 3D with the power of programming. And I'm going to make use of my favorite 3Js. Step 1. Creating a basic scene. Ta-da! This is the boilerplate code to have a plain scene. Okay, that's not interesting. Let's first get the sea. We are going to use Skybox for this. I stole a nice sea terrain image from Google and used GIMP to make it into a skybox. Now we officially have a sea. Cool! So it needs some water. I tried a few methods, but one that felt most convincing is using the official 3JS water object. The water object makes a flowing motion along with providing refraction, which is what he does. Having one object made it available only on one side, so I stacked three on top of each other in opposite directions to give the same effect on both sides. Here is the result. That looked cool. Now let's get our cutie little fishes. The world knows how big of a 3D artist I am, so let the world have some peace and continue stealing. Sketchfab has amazing 3D models, so I dropped a turtle, shark, whale, marine fish group, fish particles, an octopus, jellyfish, stingray, and hey, what are you doing here? Showing. Okay, a bag of fish. Thank you, artist. Enabling the GLTF animations makes them so lively. Excuse me, why are you not moving? To make us move from one point to another, use Queen.js, you dumb piece of s***. I gave different queen moments to each species separately, and now they just roam freely on their wonderland underworld. Then I added audio rotation, arrow movements, little tweaks, and hosted it. And the final product looks like